for opening us up today. As I said earlier, my name is Raina Gittins. I'm a communications PhD student, and my research focus is on the intersection of critical rhetoric and cultural studies. In this panel, we're focusing on enhancing the creative ways we can teach ethical decision-making in a diverse and pluralistic classroom through critical thinking. In my specific area of study and research, I have been presented with the question of how we, as 21st century instructors in a diverse and pluralistic society, teach our students how to think in ways that transform their interactions with diverse groups outside of society, in politics, at work, and in everyday communicative interactions. To be more specific, I seek to understand how we can use critical thinking techniques to help students make ethical, political, and business decisions outside of the classroom. In this presentation, I will briefly describe the problem, the proposed solution, and present a case study. As a season dubbed as post-truth, 2017 can be more easily recognized as a period where covert and hidden bias and racist rhetoric has now been brought to the surface, where it's not only minorities that recognize the bias, but a larger proportion of majority groups have come to see the dwellings of post-truth and overt racism within our community. A post-truth society presents a problem for any instructor. How do we teach students what is right and what is wrong? When information overload and alternative facts, how are students questioning many portions of their education? I argue that in order for each discipline to grapple with this problem, we must make a concerted effort to define the ethical standards of our disciplines. In the rhetorical tradition where I come from, we have ethical definitions espoused by Plato and Aristotle and Isocrates, and even some of our contemporary scholars. However, scholars in all disciplines can be effective in their classrooms by utilizing critical thinking activities that train students to apply these thoughtful processes to ethical dilemmas outside their academic halls. Other scholars have exemplified this approach in varying ways in their own classrooms. Rhetorical scholar Craig Rude argues that we need to learn civility in our classrooms because incivility threatens American democratic society. His study suggests that by teaching students to look at alternative arguments and construct their writing and speaking in a respectful manner, they create civility. Donna Kinsler, an English professor at Iowa State, encourages a critical thinking pedagogy to support ethics and communication in teaching. She states that ethical behaviors are created when students' identity assumptions seek alternative views on the subject, make connections, and become actively involved. Furthering these viewpoints, bell hooks contends that professors need to teach students how to live in the world and not just the knowledge of the books. She encourages a liberatory classroom that provides students with meaningful knowledge that connects with their overall life experiences. She does this by engaging students in personal expression. She urges that instructors remove the fear that a classroom will be antagonistic when discussions of race, sex, and gender come up in the classroom. In fact, a classroom is actually not a safe place if students feel that they cannot express themselves. In one of her literary courses, she engages students by having them all go around the room and share an experience of race in their lives. Each student shares from their own perspective, and by doing this, they gain a larger viewpoint of how race affects all of us, no matter where we come from. Her technique allows students to gain necessary perspectives and insights and opens up the classroom to have safe conversations about race, gender, and class. It also enables the instructor to learn and understand the diverse elements of his or her classroom. In my own Introduction to Human Communications course, which I've taught this year, I've been able to provide a means for students to learn communication material that applies to life outside the classroom and teach them critical thinking skills that they can use throughout their life. My greatest takeaway in all of these examples that I will share going forward is that instructors cannot shy away from bringing current issues into the classroom. Many instructors do not make space to talk about the situations that occur in our world today that affect our students when they walk in that room. In the 2016-2017 school year, we are presented with many days that affected the emotions of our students. A presidential election, the Women's March, Black Lives Matter protests, immigration bans, and more. We can no longer walk into a classroom and act like the events outside the classroom did not exist. whether we're in biology class or political science class. We must provide a space for students to talk constructively about these issues and learn how to critically think about them so that they in turn can make ethical decisions when they walk out of these academic walls. I will now go through some of the most effective critical thinking activities I've done in my course and show how these activities can actually be applied in any course. My first example is after the presidential election. I brought in 5 articles from the political sections of the newspapers, from New York Times, Washington Post, Breitbart, Huffington Post, Fox News, and of course the local AJC paper. I printed out the headlines, articles from each of those papers, and when the students walked in, I had each of them actually choose any paper they wanted. I asked them to read the paper to themselves and critically assess the article for biases, source credibility, and unanswered questions. Then the students shared and discussed their learnings. After the class, students were allowed to write a 1-to-2-page paper about their assessment, and they would gain extra credit for writing the paper. This exercise actually allowed the students to learn how to assess the news they receive for biases that may affect their own personal stereotypes and views of people who are not like them or ideas they may not agree with. They are able to understand the influence that mass media has on their own perspectives. Rather than turning away from mass media and deciding it is ineffectual, students are armed with the tools necessary to make their own assessments of the media they hear daily and make ethical decisions based on this analysis and their own guiding principles. In a second example of bringing events into the classroom, during a lesson on visual communication, I brought in the 2017 Kendall Jenner Pepsi commercial that was protested by online communities for its distasteful expression of contemporary protests. Rather than simply allowing the students to reiterate the criticisms they were seeing on Facebook, I first showed them an example of the 1960s Coca-Cola commercial that was a lot less controversial. It's actually a commercial of unity of different races over a shared love of Coke. And so first I had them watch this commercial before they even knew I was going to show them the Pepsi commercial. I allowed them to analyze that commercial, how they felt about it. And then I showed the Pepsi commercial and allowed them to do a comparison between the two commercials and tell me what were the differences. Why did the Pepsi commercial not work and why did the older Coca-Cola commercial work? By presenting a less controversial commercial first and setting the stage for the types of questions they needed to critically assess the commercials, the students were able to apply those same skills to the 2017 Pepsi commercial and talk constructively about their arguments for and against those visual displays. In addition, I often bring in current situations that I would like students to critically assess. And rather than making them in-class activities, I turn them into extra credit activities. In fall 2016, many of my students were preparing to vote for the very first time. So I asked students to listen to one of the presidential debates. After watching the debate, they were asked to choose an issue from the debate that was important to them. Obviously, we know these particular debates were difficult to find the issue in them, but I had them try as much as they could. They were asked to explain why the topic was important and then determine where each candidate stood on the issue. And if they couldn't figure that out just from watching the debate, they were asked to go to the candidate's website. Finally, they analyzed each argument. They discussed the pros and cons of both Hillary and Trump's arguments without actually stating who they were voting for. And I had them go ahead and turn that in as an extra credit assignment. In spring 2017, I modified that assignment and had the students listen to the President Trump's inaugural address and identify the presence, the coherence, and the arguments for how Trump viewed our future. Some instructors may be asking, how can I fit these things into my course if I'm not teaching a humanities course? Get creative. Rather than bringing in papers from the political section of the newspaper, you can bring in current articles from the business section, science, or international studies of the paper and have them assess critical biases or current popular topics in those respective fields. When major political events occur, students can assess how those events affect their industry. For health majors, instructors may add an assignment that critically assesses the effects of the Affordable Care Act and compare it to the Republican replacement. Environment majors can discuss the diverse issues surrounding the Dakota Access Pipeline and the political arguments over climate change. The major takeaway for instructors is that our students need to not only be equipped in the hard skills of their academic discipline, but they must be able to make ethical decisions in order to become leaders in their industries. In order to do this, they have to understand the broader societal implications of the industries they are joining and the decisions they will inevitably make. Instructors can enhance their students' ability to do this by bringing in current dilemmas and fostering an atmosphere of critical thought, argumentation, and assessment of the issues common to our society. Thank you.